the authority that we have is can only be inside us, because what is inside us is inside every living thing on this planet and wherever there is life in the universe.
I'd like to welcome to the show Dr. Ervin Laszlo. How are you doing, Ervin?
Okay, I'm fine. I'm glad to be here to talk to you.
I appreciate you coming on the show. It is an honor to speak to you about your work and about some of these big questions that we're looking for answers for in this insane world that we're living in currently. But my first question I'll ask you is, why do you think that the world is going through such a shift, such a great change right now? I mean, even in my lifetime, I've never seen such turmoil, such change in the environment, change in politics, change in governments and people's attitudes in the me kind of world, as opposed to the more connected world. Why do you think that is happening?
Well, it's an irreversible process. There's something more than what we thought. We thought it was a fluctuation, a sort of a perturbation. And after this, things will go back to where they were. It seems to me that there is something else involved here now. The best answer I can give, the best sort of term that I can use is alignment, realignment. We have got off the grid, as it were, of nature and the universe. We have went on our separate ways and destroyed the environment and creating conflict, which didn't completely destroy it, but damaged the environment and created conflict between people, rich and poor, and north and south, and human beings and other species. It's a realignment. There is something happening which is which other species would not be able to respond if they don't have this high level of consciousness. Then they don't succeed in the realignment, they become extinct. And that's a possibility that's always there for the human species as well. But we have consciousness, we have an awareness, a possibility of asking these questions that you ask, and asking also what we can do about it. So I think there is we have a chance that it is not just a perturbation, and it's also not the beginning of the end. Mm-hmm. I think it's a very serious change, an irreversible change that is moving us into another frequency, into another domain of existence, of information flow. Everything is changing. We are perhaps moving towards something different, and up to us to make that something different, something better. And by better, I mean something more natural, more aligned than what we have been, aligned with the universe, with the source. I think that is the key.
Now, can you discuss the importance of us as individuals, individual humans, to connect with our higher selves? Because there's so many people searching for that answer outside of themselves, but I found that inside is where you find the answers, and connecting to that higher self, the higher level of consciousness, is the key. But I'd love to hear your point of view.
The authority that we have can only be inside us, because what is inside us is inside every living thing on this planet and wherever there is life in the universe. The authority is in us. There is something which I call a holotropic attractor, but that's a term that we don't need to use it. But what I mean by that there is a natural tendency in us, a tropism, a natural attraction toward creating coherent higher level systems with a higher grade of consciousness or soul, if you like. And there is this push, evolutionary push and pull in the universe, which is happening all around, which is happening everywhere. And we, with our conscious mind, are capable of picking it up, of not only sort of living next to it, but absorbing it and perhaps drawing some consequences, drawing some lessons. We need to consciously further this process of realignment, of coming back to living in the web, in the womb of nature, in the lap of nature, let me say. Mm-hmm. Living in a way in which nature is and makes available for life. That's the way one can live on Earth. You know, very shortly we are going to just reminded me an hour or two ago, an invitation to the 50th anniversary of the launch of the book for the Club of Rome, which was called The Limits to Growth, 50th anniversary already. Wow. Well, to me, these limits of growth is not something negative. It just means that not anything goes. That we have, that's the first 50 years ago, this is the first time actually that humanity as a conscious species has begun to realize that not anything can be done. We cannot live any old odd way that we want to, that we are part of a living system, and that living system has its own dynamic, its own limitations, but it's also its own possibilities. So it's time now, after 50 years, to come back and to reflect, how is it that we can again be part of this evolutionary trend? We are now, a part of it, but conscious can we be consciously a part of it? That's what I want to say.
So what is the definition of consciousness? What is your definition of consciousness? What is it?
I don't think anybody can, but it's what we used to call soul or spirit. Mm-hmm. I think it's close to what we can call consciousness. It's something of which there is only one, if that is helpful.
Okay, fair enough.
As Schrödinger said, the consciousness it doesn't exist in the plural. Consciousness is a spirit which exists in the world, which is non-material, but perhaps the material is really more or less of an illusion. Perhaps what really exists is this higher level. If this spirit is this non-material something which we can't name, because everything else that by which we would name is a result of it, sort of. But it's the consciousness is that universal awareness which makes the world more than a set of material objects vying with one another and surviving or not surviving. Something more, something deeper. There is this spirit which already Plato talked about, the life, the consciousness, the mind, you know. Mm-hmm. We can call it by many names, but it is something which is fundamental in the world, which is probably much more fundamental than anything physical or material. The rest could be a manifestation of this. Ultimately, what there is mind, is spirit, is consciousness.
Now, you've spoken about the Akashic Field a lot. What is the Akashic Field for people listening who don't know it?
It's the way the universe appears to us. Okay. The universe is a continuous field as we apprehend it, and where all things are interconnected, where all things are acting together. Sometimes we can disturb it, of course, and then we are out of sync. But in this field, which is the universe as it appears, the field of life, the field of consciousness, where everything joins together, where everything acts toward a single basic aim, which we can call evolution, which we can best define as a higher level of coherence of all things resonating with each other. So the Akasha is the Akashic Field, is a field of interconnection, a field of oneness, and a field of joint one system evolution, a field of mind, really. I don't know if that's why that's very much more helpful, but sure. This is what the Akasha is really intuitively has been perceived for thousands of years. There is something which is a continuous, unbroken wholeness, and that appears to us as a field, and that, you can say, is the Akashic Field.
Now, why has there been such a move from connection and understanding connection, not only to nature, but to each other? Because earlier, hundreds of years ago, even thousands of years ago, people were much more interconnected, much more reliant on each other. It was known that you needed to be connected with nature and work with nature. But in these last couple hundred years, even, we have now, especially these last 50 years, have really kind of like supercharged our disconnecting from not only each other, the concept of the oneness, the concept of being interconnected as one entity, as a humanity, but also as a planet. Why do you think this is happening?
It has become a precondition of our survival. There's just no other way. We are on the threshold of what is known as the sixth global extinction, wave of extinction. And we wonder if the human species will be part of this wave of extinctions. Certainly there's no guarantee that we can survive. But if there is any chance that we have, then if we not only survive, but we move forward. We can't stay the way we were, we can't go back, but we can reach to a higher level of spirit or soul or mind or consciousness, as you like.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the chance that is given to us to be conscious of this tremendous change, that we need to change, that we need it, because the way we have been going has been a recipe for disaster, for a species-wide disaster, creating an unlivable, unsustainable world in which humans are there as conflictual elements, feeling ever more disturbed, ever more frustrated, ever more violent, because we don't live out what we truly are, this oneness, this coherence-oriented system. So this has got to change. It has got to the point where it needed to change. We're beginning to perceive that change now consciously. It's there anyway. Other species undergo these changes and they either mutate or they become extinct. We can perceive it. We can be consciously perceive it. And if we are bright enough, sufficiently bright and clever enough, we can also align ourselves consciously. Consciously seeking harmony, seeking coherence, seeking oneness. This has been intuitively the case for thousands of years. Now we recognize that this is part of the evolutionary drive. All things seek oneness. We are part of this, all things. And we have not been seeking it. We have got off this train. We thought we can take a faster train or go to wherever we want to go. And we are now feeling the consequences. We can't continue doing this. We have to come back to what we really are, a natural entity evolving in harmony with the rest of life on this planet.
How do you suggest that we reconnect with source? Because I feel a lot of our problems is a disconnection from the source energy, from the thing that created us, whatever title or label you'd like to put on it, but God, the universe, the inner, whatever that is. How do you suggest that we reconnect with that source?
Well, there's no simple, very short answer to that. as this happens, last year, I published a book precisely with this title, Reconnecting to the Source. St. Martin's Press, you know, about 200 pages or so. I'll try to give an answer.
Okay.
But what strikes me is that whenever you talk to people, and I've tried to do this, but even in this book, Reconnecting to the Source, I talk to people who are believed to be highly spiritual entities, people with a higher level of spirituality. What it is that distinguishes them, that makes them different from ordinary, everyday variety of people. And I think there is this something, this seeking, this search for coherence, for union, in integrity, in the diversity, within the diversity, not monolithic oneness, but a higher level of coherence, seeking that. And when you seek that, when you search for that, then you express something that young people call love, or romantic poets have called love, and I can also call it that. Because love in this ultimate sense means not doing something for something or against in return to something. it means an unconditional and universal sense that we are seeking or belonging with the rest, belonging to this place. You call it universe, it sounds always very big to call it universe. It seems like a lot of galaxies and stars twinkling and all that, and very impersonal. But it turns out the universe has born, if that's really truly the case, as we believe it in science, it is. At a certain point, 8 billion years ago, after the aftermath of the Big Bang, and there has been an initial chaos which is organizing itself all along, creating entities, creating coherent things, atoms and molecules and cells and ecologies, systems of life, galactic systems, and so on. All of this is happening. The initial chaos is giving rise to additional levels of chaos, additional level of coherence, rather. And we are part of this movement. And the point that I'm trying to make today is that this is a very major realignment, which we can help, which we can live up to, which we can try to work with if we do it consciously. We realign to that evolutionary trend, which I call the holotropism. Holo is for wholeness, you know, a tropism toward wholeness, toward oneness, you know. If you can realign with that and feel the oneness, feel the love, okay, then there's a chance, I think, that we can create a human system on this planet which is aligned with the web of life throughout this planet and throughout nature.
Do you think that we are in a sense in chaos at the moment, because we need to, within chaos starts the growth process of being able to shift to that next place, because it seems fairly chaotic right now in the world?
We are in transition.
Yeah.
This, what you call chaos, is our hope, is our chance, is the opportunity, because it loosens up what there was. To have continued the way we have been going would have been very bad, suicidal. There's a nice Chinese saying which says, if you continue the way, if you don't change direction, you'll end up exactly to where we have been heading for.
Very great.
But it's now we desperately need of change of direction. And in fact, it's not even a question of whether change direction, because we can't keep on the way we have been. But the question is, what direction can we find that way? Can we find, which is sometimes referred to as a new normalcy, the new norm, the norm which is in nature, which is in the universe, and which is in us, which we have forgotten. We have completely bypassed any natural limitations on any natural search for coherence that is given to us. We thought we can do anything that we want, as long as we don't break the law, don't be sent to prison, and as long as it makes money, we can do anything. And there is the technology to help us make it do it, you know. And this kind of sophistry, this kind of hubris, you might say, you know, to push us outside of nature, above the universe, that is what we've got to overcome. But we are overcoming it now. Hopefully, and not paying the ultimate price, which is extinction. The real, the payoff for this is a higher level of coherence between people and nature, and between this planet and the rest of the universe. That is the ultimate payoff. That is what we have to search for and seek, and that is what we are seeking, because it's in us. If we would only listen, as you said a moment ago, the inner authority, the inner impulse, that is our guide. Not any rationalization, not any objectives and commands from the outside. Listen to yourself and become again part of this universe. You will live well. You live at home.
Now, how do you suggest that we raise the consciousness of humanity as a whole? Because that is what's going to be needed for this shift.
Well, we are raising it already. This tremendous trial that we are going through, this global crisis, is raising, is doing just that, is shaking us up. We need to be conscious of it, recognize that this is taking place and that we can be a part of it. Back to nature, back to the universe. This is not reversing. It's not going back to something past. It's going to a higher unity, recognizing truly who we are. All sayings, the wisdom of the Greek prophetess is find out who are you. Ask yourself who you are. And this is finally this our chance. We are being asked to ask. We are prompting to ask. And by us raising this question, taking it seriously, asking us, we can ask ourselves, how do we align? How do we become one again? How do we seek that oneness which is around us? Okay. We have a short time left. I mean, not only in this program, yes, but in the evolutionary time of the species. We have to make use of that time.
So let me ask you then, and I've heard you speak about this before, what is the ultimate truth of the universe, in your opinion?
It seems to me that the universe moves from chaos to coherence, from disorder, from chance, from randomness, toward order, but not a pre-created mechanistic order, deterministic order, but a self-motivated seeking toward higher levels, using these poetic terms of oneness, of belongingness, higher levels of work, of feeling ourselves together. There is something in that direction which is now going on. It is becoming more and more unlikely that we simply go back to where we have been before this crisis. We could reverse the clock and then just pick it up from there. There is something new coming to be born, and it's up to our conscious mind, up to our consciousness, our soul, if you like, is to pick that up, to resonate with it, and to work with it, seeking the oneness, seeking the coherence. Okay, it sounds, poetic, but if we don't do it, we can't survive on this planet. If you really do it consciously, we can find the way to live in harmony and the way to survive, because life is not chaotic. Life is coherent. And we have lost that. We have got to find it again. Join that coherence, which is life in the universe.
Are you hopeful for the future of humanity?
I think the very fact that we are here and talking about these things is a hopeful sign. I think we have a chance, we have an opportunity. I wouldn't say it as a forecast, but that we can ask these questions, and people are asking about these questions, and they're asking for answers, they're asking themselves also. That is a wonderful, a great sign. We are not going blindly into our demise. We are becoming, recognizing that we are at a crossroads, at a crossing of the path ahead, a bifurcation, and we are trying to move forward in that direction. A hopeful thing.
Why do you think that there are so many forces within humanity that want to go back to the way things were, that say, that magical time in their minds that was perfect and everything, but they want to keep going back as opposed to opening up for this change? What do you think?
Well, back to what?
Exactly.
If you just go back to what we have been having up to 2-3 years ago, the industrial civilization, where anything goes as long as it makes money, and we are all separate beings competing with one another. If that's what we go back to, that's suicidal. But we can go back to a deeper sense of who we are, the great, great prophets told us that we are one, okay? We can move forward in that direction. That's the way to go back to go back to the oneness that is there in the universe. This universe which is moving towards coherence. I keep saying that because that I think is absolutely key. The universe is a system that moves toward wholeness and higher levels of order and comprehension and higher levels of consciousness. Okay, that's a fantastic, magical universe. Let me just say one quote then before we end. Mm-hmm. Einstein said at one point, he said, you can live, there are two ways to live your life, as if everything is a miracle or as if nothing is. We used to think that nothing is a miracle. Everything is just a mechanical, physical process. And mind and all that is just imagination. The new recognition that we come to is that mind and soul and consciousness are not only primary, they are it. The universe is that, you know. Not that it is possessed, but the universe is this higher level of consciousness, which evolves. And we can help it to evolve. We can be part of that evolution. We can be part of the development whereby life becomes a supreme force on this planet, and from this planet perhaps can radiate outwards. And through the non-local immediate transmission of information, reach other planets, reach other forms of life, until all life becomes finally in service of the wholeness toward which the universe is heading.
Dr. Laszlo, I really appreciate you taking the time to come on. Where can people find out more about your books and about your work?
Right now, on the 22nd of February, I have an event, an online event, the Laszlo Upshift Festival. So that is a good thing to join that. Otherwise, you can find the LaszloInstitute.com has all about my activities. Ervin Laszlo Books lists all my books. And the latest book is this called Upshift, Wiser Living on Planet Earth, a hopeful book showing that it can happen. And that is will be available probably in about 10 days' time. In the meanwhile, look up the Upshift Festival, mm-hmm. Laszlo Upshift Festival, and join it. You can send your videos, you can send your comments. It's an open system where we are trying to bring forward-looking, open people together to cope with that tremendous challenge of the crisis through which we are living.
Dr. Laszlo, thank you again so much for coming on the show. I appreciate what you do, your work, your life's work, and continue. You do not stop. You are working constantly trying to help humanity. So I truly appreciate you, my friend. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I can't help it, I should say. It's built into me. I think it's built into all of us. Let's just obey it. Let's just align with it. Thank you for your question.
Thanks for watching. Click on one of the videos below to continue your journey. And don't forget to subscribe.